This video is going to be perfect for you if you're looking to start your eBay dropshipping journey, because what I'm going to be doing is going through the 5 most common questions that I get asked on this channel. Let's go. What's going on, people? Welcome back to my channel. If you're new, my name is Sam, and what I do here is break down various different tips and tricks when it comes to making money online. But in today's video, what I'm going to be doing is going through the most common asked questions that I get when it comes to eBay dropshipping. Whether I get asked the questions in the comments down below or on my Instagram DMs, I'm going to go through the top 5 questions that I get asked specifically when it comes to eBay dropshipping. So make sure you stick around to the end so that you don't miss anything. As always, I don't want to waste any more time. I want to get right into it. So if you find any value in the video at any point, don't forget to press the like button. Don't forget to subscribe as well. Hit the bell notification so that YouTube can let you know when a new video has been released. Let's not waste any more time. Let's get right into it. So one of the first questions that I'm going to answer is, Sam, the product cost is too high. How am I able to make any profit or even make any sales in the first place? Now, one thing that all of you guys need to know is that when it comes to doing eBay dropshipping, it's a numbers game. And what I mean by that is you're going to need to list as many products on your eBay store as possible for you to be able to make as many sales as possible. So it's not just a case of listing one product or two products, specifically when it comes to eBay dropshipping, because you're going to need as many listings as possible for multiple different products for you to have the best chance of being able to make a sale. Reason being is that when you decide to do eBay dropshipping, automatically your prices are going to be a lot higher than your competitors, because what they're doing is that they're importing products in bulk. And when you import products in bulk, you're going to be able to get the unit cost down. So if you do plan on doing eBay dropshipping and building your eBay business this way, you're going to have multiple different listings for multiple different products for you to be able to capture sales here and there. So going back to the initial question, which is that the product cost is too high, how am I going to be able to make any sales? Even though the product cost might be high, it's just a case of you listing it for the price that you need to list it at for you to make the profit. So just because you're looking at the price of the product that it's going to cost you doesn't mean that you automatically need to think that you're not going to be able to make a sale or you're not going to be able to make profit. As long as you do everything that you need to do for you to appear high in the eBay search results, that's the main thing that you need to work on. Because if you do everything that you need to do in terms of eBay SEO, making sure that you've designed your listing in the best possible way, making sure that you've branded your store in the best possible way, you're going to be able to list your product for whatever price you want to, because customers are more likely going to come across your listing rather than your competitors. But it's all about making sure that you've got multiple different listings and multiple different products available, because as I already said at the start, eBay dropshipping is a numbers game. So it's your job to make sure that you've listed as many products as possible. And that's why I'm always teaching you guys on this channel that it's very important to make sure that you're increasing your eBay selling limit, because the higher your limit is, the more products that you can list, the more products that you can list, the more money that you can potentially make. Moving on to one of the next questions that I get, which is that eBay closed my account because I started dropshipping. What can I do about it? Now, eBay doesn't always give a reason as to why they've closed your account. It could be due to a number of different things. It could be due to the fact that you didn't verify your details when you signed up. You didn't give them the accurate details in terms of your name, date of birth, bank details, things like that. Doing certain things when you first sign up could potentially cause them to want to close down your account. So it might not be due to the fact that you started dropshipping, but if you do know for a fact that it was because you was dropshipping, maybe because someone told you, you called up and someone told you over the phone that you was dropshipping, that's the reason why they closed your account. It might be due to the fact that you was dropshipping from a marketplace when that's not what you're supposed to do. eBay has a policy in place when it comes to what you can do and what you can't do when it comes to dropshipping on their platform. And it's very important to make sure that you go through it so that you do the right things from the moment that you sign up. Because once you've made a mistake, you break one of their rules and eBay notice it, they're going to close down your account, and it's going to be quite difficult for you to open up another account with the same details. And that's why I always advise any person that's looking to start dropshipping on eBay to go onto this article, because eBay breaks down what you're allowed to do and what you can't do specifically when it comes to dropshipping on their platform. As you can see right there, it says dropshipping where you fulfill orders directly from a wholesale supplier is allowed on eBay. But down here it says, however, listing an item on eBay and then purchasing it from another retailer or marketplace that ships directly to your customer is not allowed on eBay. Activity that doesn't follow eBay's policy could result in a range of actions, including canceling listings, demoting your listings from the search results, buying or selling restrictions, etc., etc. And basically what eBay is saying right here is that you're allowed to dropship on their platform as long as you use a company that is specific for dropshipping. They don't want you to use one of their direct competitors, for example, Walmart or Amazon. And this is one of the most common mistakes that a lot of new dropshippers make, is that they sign up to eBay and straight away they start dropshipping from Amazon. And the reason why eBay is able to know that you're dropshipping from places like Amazon is due to the fact that the tracking number that you're going to get from Amazon when you place an order through them, that you're now going to give to your customer on eBay, is very unique to Amazon, and it's going to trigger eBay system to know that this is what you're doing. So it's very important to make sure that you go through this page, read through everything before you sign up to eBay, so that you don't end up in a situation where you end up getting your account banned or restricted. Now, moving on to one of the next common questions that I get, which is eBay dropshipping better than Shopify dropshipping? So one of the main benefits of using eBay when it comes to building up your dropshipping business is due to the fact that there's a lot of free traffic that you're going to be able to get. However, when it comes to doing Shopify dropshipping, you're going to have to pay for people to visit your website. eBay currently has around 200 to 300 million active visitors that visit eBay every single month, which means that you're going to benefit from a lot of that free traffic. I would say that that's one of the biggest benefits when it comes to doing dropshipping on eBay, is that you're not necessarily going to have to pay for any advertising. However, when it comes to doing Shopify dropshipping, you're definitely going to have to pay for some sort of ads to get customers onto your website. However, the main benefit of doing Shopify dropshipping rather than eBay dropshipping is that you're not necessarily going to have to build up your account just for you to start getting sales. As a complete beginner, when it comes to signing up to eBay, you're going to have to build up your feedback. You're going to have to build up your selling limit. However, you don't have to do those things on Shopify. You can start a store today and start generating sales. And plus, you don't have the feeling of getting banned just because you're dropshipping. However, eBay, you kind of have to tiptoe around the fact that you can't use specific suppliers that you might want to use. So these are just some of the things that you need to consider before you start dropshipping on any one of these platforms. But in my opinion, I believe that both of them are beneficial in their own way. It all depends on what you're comfortable doing, and you can do both at the same time. Because you're not necessarily buying stock, you can play around with both. You can build up your eBay dropshipping business at the same time as doing Shopify dropshipping, because it doesn't take too much time for you to build up any one of these platforms. And because you don't need that much money when it comes to dropshipping on eBay or Shopify, there's no harm in trying both. So moving on to one of the next questions that I get, which is, should I dropship from the very beginning or should I import stock straight away? So if you're new to the world of selling on eBay, there's two main ways that you can do it. You can either import stock from places like China, or what you could do is that you could dropship. Now, of course, when it comes to dropshipping, you're not necessarily going to have to spend a lot of money to get things started. However, when it comes to importing stock, you're going to have to spend some sort of money to buy the stock in bulk. And there's various different benefits and disadvantages when it comes to doing either one of these options. One of the main benefits of importing products in bulk is that you're going to be able to get the unit cost down for each product, which means that you're going to be able to remain a little bit more competitive when it comes to pricing your items. However, because you're spending a larger amount on each product when you're dropshipping, it's going to be harder for you to compete with a lot of the sellers. But going back to the initial question, which is, which one should you do, import stock or dropship? It all depends on what budget you have. If you have a decent amount of money to start your business, in my opinion, it might make more sense for you to buy the products in bulk, as long as you've done the right product research to make sure that the products is definitely selling well. And as long as you've also made sure to set up your eBay store in the right way, make sure that everything is structured, make sure that you've designed your store in the right way, you've picked the right branding, you've done everything right in terms of the selling limit as well as your feedback. If you've done all of these different things and you've made sure that the product is definitely selling well, then it wouldn't necessarily hurt for you to import products in bulk. But the most important thing is that you need to make sure that you've got a backup plan and that you've accepted any risk that's going to come with it. And you have to also make sure that you don't go too crazy. You need to make sure that you build up your business bit by bit. So you need to start off small and then scale it up slowly over time. That's what I did anyway. For my first import that I did, it was around $2,000. What I did is that I got that, sold it, and then the next shipment was around $3,000. I got that and sold that, and then from there I built it up. One common mistake that a lot of people make when they first start importing products in bulk is that they go a little bit overboard and they import around $20,000 worth of stock without even knowing if they're going to be able to sell it. It's very important to make sure that you start off with around 20 units, see if you can sell that, and then increase it to 40 units the second time around, and then 50 units, and then 100 units. But whatever the case is, you need to make sure that you've proven to yourself that you can definitely sell it before you start importing a large amount of stock. So just quickly going back to the initial question again, which is, which one is better, importing stock or dropshipping? If you have some sort of budget or you have some sort of money to invest in your business and you've done the right research, then importing products in bulk is better. But if you don't necessarily have that, then you can go down the route of dropshipping so that you can build up that capital so that you can now invest into the products down the line. So moving on to one of the final questions that I'm going to answer in today's video, which is, Sam, which supplier is the best one to use when it comes to doing eBay dropshipping? So there's so many different suppliers that are available for you to use, and I'm going to go through the list in a moment, but it's very important that whatever one you do pick is going to be able to offer quick, delivery to your customers. That's one of the most important things. And you also need to make sure that the quality of the item that the supplier is going to send out is one of the best, because you don't want your customers to complain, because that's going to affect your eBay account. Now, when it comes to using any dropshipping supplier for any one of my eBay stores, the way that I like to connect my eBay store to the supplier's website is by using AutoDS. So AutoDS is a software that's going to enable you to automate the whole dropshipping process in terms of the listing process, as well as the fulfillment side of things as well. And the suppliers that are currently available for you to use on AutoDS right now are websites like Amazon, AliExpress, Walmart, Costco, Etsy. You can even do eBay to eBay dropshipping, CJ dropshipping, Alibaba. There's so many different suppliers that you can use if you want to use AutoDS when it comes to automating the whole listing process and fulfillment process. Now, I made a video not too long ago, about a week ago, where I broke down exactly how you can use AutoDS when it comes to building up your eBay dropshipping business from scratch. I'm going to leave that video right there. Make sure you watch that video straight after this one, because it's helped out so many people. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to press the like button. Don't forget to subscribe as well. Hit the bell notification so that YouTube can let you know when a new video has been released. All right, guys, I'll see you on the next one. Make sure you stay safe out there. Peace.